Welcome to the Great Exodus series, God's plan of rescue for his children. Let my people go, the path to Mount Zion. My name is Michael, I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And our topic today is about equality and humility. We must remain humble, no matter how successful we are in the Lord and how close we are walking with the Lord. Actually, if we walk closer and closer with him, we become more and more humble. And we also have to come to unite. We have to stop our bickering. The church that we are the people, we are the church. We have to come in love, together in love, unity and support. And inequality. Nobody is elevated before the Lord. Nobody. I am the founder of Triple Grace, but I'm not higher than any of the members of Triple Grace. I'm not higher than any of the members. I'm not higher than the least in Triple Grace or the least in the church. We are all equal because we are also all equally blessed by our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So let us remain and stay in humility and equality. And not to elevate ourselves with positions. Oh, this is a pastor and the other one is even a bishop or whatever. For what purpose? These are worldly honors and we do not care about worldly honors. What we care about is the heavenly kingdom. So let us turn our backs towards the world and towards Babylon and come out and build a new church. 2020 is, if you put it together, it's a number four. A number four is in the Jewish alphabet, the dalet, the door, an open door. Now it's the time to open that door and to walk that narrow and righteous path. 2020 will see a lot of dwelling places to be established in the nations. The true church of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ will be formed, and they will be a humble church and a church that stays in equality. Everybody is equal. Yes, there will be an elder, two elders, a man and a woman, leading or guiding, let's put it better this way, guiding a dwelling place of Zion. But they are still equal, like the other ones, and all the decisions will be made together. In the same way as it was in the home churches of the early Christians, all the decisions were made together. Now it's the time to restore the altar to its former glory. Now it's the time to fall down on our knees and to pray to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and say, we as your bride are ready. Come and take us, send us your spirit so that we can walk with him together every day, wherever you go. It's the time now to open that door and to step onto the narrow and righteous path towards the holy mountain, towards Mount Zion, so that we can clean our garments in the blood of the Lamb, and that we can stay in fine white linen as a multitude at the sixth seal, and that we then can be raptured into paradise or be sealed as one of the 144,000. So let us come together. Now it's a year, now it's a time to build the dwelling places of Zion. Everybody can establish a home church in his place. Everybody can gather the people together. And you will receive the Holy Spirit to train and teach him and to send them as disciples of our Lord and Savior into the neighborhoods to lift up the needy, the nameless and faceless and to do our daily sacrifice of love. Because we sacrifice ourselves daily for the Lord. We die daily for our Lord because we are his bride and we love him so much. Now it's the time to come out of your halls, out of the churches, out of the world, and out of Babylon, the Jezebel spirit, and take a stand, like on Mount Carmel with Elijah. Take a stand now for the heavenly kingdom. But never forget, everything must be done in humility, so that you stay humble always, and in equality. None is elevated before the Lord. We are all his children, his two sons and daughters. So it must be equality. Let us all have one in one accord, the accord to spread the gospel of the kingdom and to win souls. Let us have all in common, because we are a big family. The churches, the home churches, the dwelling places of Zion, are a big family, no matter from where you are. A dwelling place in Africa will be part of the family in Asia, and this too will be part of the family in the US or in Europe. Everywhere we are a big family, and we will come together in love, unity, and support. And no matter what comes towards us, the Antichrist and the false prophet, and no matter how much persecution will come forward us, we will never walk away from that righteous and narrow path, but we will support one another, no matter how difficult the situation will be, and we will take a stand for our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ right now, but remain in humility and equality. And understand that nobody is elevated before him, no matter how you feel that you have a spiritual gift and that you might think you are better than others, but you are not. We are all equal. Because the Lord has given us spiritual gifts so that we can bless our community, that we can bless the dwelling places, that we can bless the other members, and that we can train and teach them, and that we can walk all together in the same way as the Israelites came out of Egypt and walked together through the wilderness towards the mountain. We will also come out now out of the world and out of Babylon in the great Exodus, and we will walk towards the holy mountain that's not carved by human hands, and that will come down at the sixth seal, Mount Zion. And there we will be raptured into paradise. We do not have much time now. But let us come together and let us bring in the harvest of the ages. Let us go forth into our neighborhoods, to the small ones, to the poor, to the nameless, to the one who were always stepped onto, the ones that have suffered a lot, the ones who were never the rich one or the famous ones. Let us go to the small ones, because Jesus said, the poor will inherit the kingdom, and the last will be the first. Now it's the time to lift up these people and to make a church out of them, a church that is so blessed, a church that will walk in wonders and miracles, a church that will show forth the love of the Father forever and ever, and a church that will be raptured into paradise. Now it's the time. 2020 is your time. Right now, start to prepare and start a home church in your house. This is your time now. I'm calling you forth. Do not miss the end-time church. Do not miss it, the step in 2020. This is our year. This is your year. Let us come together as a big family, as a family of the Lord, as a bride of Christ, as a true son and daughters of the Most High. This is your time. But never forget, stay humble and equal. Thank you that you have listened to this topic. And today is the 31st of December 2019. We do not know what will happen today. All what I know is that 2020 is our year. It's a year of the true bride. It's a year of the children of the Most High. And I know we will establish so many home churches in that year, because the Holy Spirit will come down on us and we will be able to establish them even in the darkest places. Now it's the time. And because today is the 31st of December 2019, I will wish you all a happy new year. And please pray to the Lord. Say, open up my way in 2020 so that I can establish a home church, that I can be part of that big family that you call your bride, and that the Father calls his true sons and daughters. It's your time now. Thank you that you have listened to this topic today, and I hope I will see you again, all of you, tomorrow in the new year. Have a blessed day and a blessed night. Maranatha.